Hi, I'm Mike Maxey. Welcome to this tutorial on starting a private ACME server using Smallstep Certificate Manager. As you can see, I'm starting out here in our docs under our ACME server. And to set this up, it's really three steps. The first is to create an authority. The second is to configure a local ACME RA, which is a piece of infrastructure that runs locally to validate requests. And then lastly, you need to configure your ACME client. And we're going to jump through all three of these today. So let's start with the first one, which is creating your team and your authority. Now I've already created a team over here. I'm going to go ahead and click this big orange button and create an authority. Let's call it demo. And then let's go ahead and click create. Now what happens here is we've created a new intermediate authority. It's online and available at this particular URL. It also has a unique fingerprint, which we've calculated and we'll use in some of our commands a bit down the road. You'll also notice we've created a provisioner called Authority Admin. This is your way of authenticating requests to the CA, adding sensitive materials, etc. We'll also use that in a bit. But first, we want to configure our client to use this new authority I just created. So down here in the quick actions, I'm going to click this command, which is configure step CLI. And then over here in my command line terminal, I'm going to run that command. And you'll see that I've downloaded the root for this particular CA, and I've also configured my local client to use this CA. So that's it. I have a client that's configured. I have an active authority. Let's go back to our instructions. The second step of these instructions is now creating a registration authority. So in there, we're going to do a couple things. We're going to set up a local piece of infrastructure that can act as the ACME gateway or the ACME proxy to your CA. Validate those requests, and then send them back. So let's jump into that. The first thing we need to do is create a new provisioner, which is a way to access your CA. So I'm going to take this command. I'm going to go ahead and run it over here in this window. And when I do, it's going to ask me for some credentials. And this is your login to Smallstep. And this is that first provisioner I mentioned. So I enter my email, and it's going to send me through a single sign-on flow in my browser and ask me to verify access. Once that's verified, back here in the command line, you'll see it's asking me for a password. I give it a password, and it creates, this out of the way, it creates a new provisioner. So that's it. We've created a new provisioner, and we can now move on to the second step of configuring our RA. And in this section, we're going to create a new JSON template and then apply it to a local step CA configuration so it can stand up as a registration authority. So to do that, we need to create a new text file or a new file called ca.json. So I'm going to use my code editor here. And when I open that up, I'll have a blank file. Over here in the documentation, I'm going to go ahead and copy all this information. Drop it back here into my CA JSON file. So this is a configuration file for your registration authority. And there's a few things that we need to put in here. So I'm going to change my port, because I'm running on my local host here, to 9123. I'm going to change my DNS name to localhost. And I'm going to change my data source to where my step file lives. For me, that's ./.step. And then I also, so that's sort of the setup of my localhost. This next section is around the authority or the signing piece. And because this type is step CA, it's basically telling the local configuration, I'm not a signing authority, I'm a registration authority. Here's the signing authority information. And we're gonna pull that from the dashboard on the authority we just created. So the first thing we need is the CA URL. So I'm gonna copy that here and paste that there, and then secondarily the fingerprint. So let me get a copy of my fingerprint, and I'm going to go ahead and paste that fingerprint over here, ideally without the extra spaces. So that's my CA. It'll now know where to go to find my CA, and then it's going to ask, how do I authenticate to the CA? And that's using that provisioner we just created in the last step, JWK with this name. That's the CA information. The next section is, as a registration authority, what provisioners or how should clients authenticate to me? And as you can see, we're turning on ACME. We have other options here, but in this example, we're running ACME. the cipher suites, etc., you don't really need to mess with. So I'm going to save this file, and then I'm going to go back to my terminal. And let's get a clean view here, and then let's make sure my changes came through. It looks like they did. So I'm ready to now start my registration authority. And to do that, I type step-ca, ca.json. It's asking me now for that password that I used to create the provisioner. So a couple steps ago, we created a provisioner password. I'm gonna go ahead and enter that now. And now I need to pause. Okay, looks like I have a bind address. So I've gone and I've updated my ca.json file. So let's cat, and I've chosen a new port, 9124. So let's start this again. Let's do step-ca, ca.json. There it goes, it's asking me for my password. And there you go. It's now up and running, and it outputted its own root fingerprint. So this is the fingerprint for the RA, which we're going to use here in just a second. If I come back over here in my browser, you can see I do have my ACME provisioner all set up, and everything's ready to go here. So there you go. I've now set up the registration authority. The next step is to test an actual client. So I'm going to create a new terminal window. And in this terminal, I'm going to act as an ACME client. So the first thing that I need to do as an ACME client is I need to bootstrap into that ACME registration authority I just created. So I'm going to go ahead and run the bootstrap command. So that's step-ca bootstrap --ca-url, and that is our localhost port 9124, and then I need to give it a fingerprint. Oops, fingerprint, and that value I got output from right here. So let's copy that, provide my fingerprint, and hit enter. Helps if I can spell. Let's fix the boot. And yeah, we'll bootstrap into this. Okay, now I have set up my client bootstrapped into the ACME RA. Last thing I need to do is request a certificate. So I'm going to go step-ca certificate with the name localhost. This is where you'd put your DNS information. And let's save it in l.cert l.key. And as you can see, I've just run an ACME HTTP challenge and I've gotten a new key. I can inspect that. L.cert-cert. And you can see I have a new certificate issued by our ACME RA from the intermediate authority I just created. It's valid for 24 hours, which is our default. So there you go. That's the basic setup. I hit a few bumps along the way, but hopefully you followed along. In the end, a lot of this is super configurable. You don't need to manually type passwords. There's lots of ways to automate different portions of this, so reach out. We're happy to explain all of that. But hopefully this gets you up and running in less than 10 minutes, and good luck. Reach out with questions, and we appreciate all feedback. Thank you.